Hello everybody out there, YouTube line, it's the one and only Insanity here with call update number 12. This is by far the longest call update that you ever gonna see from me. First off, we're gonna start off with Ambrose's new attire that you haven't seen yet. It is a Heath Slater idea. Heath Slater's new attire, I seen it the first time he wore it. I forgot what pay-per-view it was, but the first time he wore it, I seen it, and I automatically said, I am doing that attire. I really like those pants and whatnot, so I decided to do that attire. Now, it's not exactly the same because, of course, I'm not going to do it exactly the same because I like to be original. I like to say I still keep my ideas and everything original, even though they are taken from another, source or whatever the case may be, but I still want to say my shit is original, so it is. It's not exactly the way he has it. The designs are similar. I messed up right there, sorry about that. The designs are similar, but I decided to go my own thing, and it came out very well. Very, 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 very well. As you see, the kick pads, kind of dope. That A on his knee pass, though, is just sickening me. It's very sickening me. Like, that A is just so... That's one thing about me, man. I could tell you, like, not every attire that I do or every idea that I get, I always stick with. Sometimes, most of the time, I always change my mind when it comes to certain things. And, like, nothing is ever, permanent unless I actually say it's permanent. But yeah, this attire came out great, and Donquise 29 said I should keep that attire for him every time I create him. Just have like a different pattern. And now we're gonna see Liger. Liger's attire, I don't know if y'all seen this or not. I don't think y'all did, but I kinda went with the Owen Hart type feel to this. Owen Hart actually has a design like that, but it has a crown instead of the maple leaf, of course. And it says King of Hearts under the crown. No, it says the King of Hearts in between the two lions. And then it has Owen on the little leg part where I got it saying Liger. And then the kick pads, I was just lazy. I was like, let me see if I can work with the kick with the design that I already put on it. And it actually came out dope. The kick pads are a little puffy, but there's a reason why the kick pads are a little puffy. That reason I'm not going to say yet, but yeah. Orion Star, I don't know if you ever seen Orion Star original WWE 12 attire, but here it is. It's decent for what it is. I don't like the back of his briefs. I don't like the back of his briefs at all, but everything else I think is dope. And Orion Star, if you didn't know, I think Orion Star is like the best character that I have ever created. It's like he's just so well put together, like when it comes to his tattoos and everything. If you just take a quick second to just look at the tattoos, man. Tattoos, awesome. I think he has the best tattoos that I ever did. And like, he's just so well put together. Even though like this attire right here that you're seeing right now is like completely random. Like, there's no idea, no thought process went into this attire at all. So, it just came out this way. But it's dope. You got the entrance attire coming up right now. I can honestly say the vest should have been done a little bit better, but it is what it is. I was lazy. I didn't feel like making another paint too for his vest. So, yeah. You got Orion going across that shit under it. But speaking of Orion Star, I'm about to show you the Bastard's attire. Y'all seen the Bastard's attire in the first episode, which I haven't seen it up close yet. And here is the Bastard's attire. Now with the Bastard's attire, I didn't have an idea for the attire neither. I drew the paint to the logo with the Bastard's and pretty much just thought of what I can do with it. As you can see, the face, that's Orion Star's face, but you can hardly see the actual detail in it. He has his glasses on, his Hollywood glasses on, he has a goatee, but you can't see it. It's like a hologram type shit because of the colors and shit. It's like a hologram. Like, if I turn it a certain way, you can see it. But as you can see, the Bastard's on the back. I now when I'm looking at it, like I said, it always changed my mind. I don't really like the fucking the logo, the bastards. I really don't like it because it just looks plain. Like, I could have done something way better, but you know, who knows? In the future, the bastards attire might change. But as you can see, he has the stars all over the place. He has the CM Punk kick pads right now with the stars in it and whatnot. And I thought, you know, that'd be a good idea to have both Majestic and Orion with the same boots, but, you know, different patterns or different designs inside the kick pad. And I was having fun creating these faces. I really did. I'm not really too fond of how Orion's face came out due to the fact that you could barely see, you know, the details. But I love the way Majestic's face came out. It was like, I don't know. It was like American Japanese tag team put together. I don't know. It was just funny to create their faces. That's a t-shirt, the Bastard t-shirt. And here goes Majestic's attire. Now, of course, we all know that RTW Attitude takes place like 2 years after NWF. So Majestic grew out his hair. He got a couple piercings and things of that nature. And, you know, with the tattoo design, I put the M on the back of his neck. I think he always had the M on the back of his neck. But with the tattoo idea, it was supposed to be a dragon at first when I first created Majestic. But the way it came out, it just looked bad. Like, it just looked like a whole bunch of shit made down into a line. So I decided, well, the skulls look decent if you line them up. So let me just, you know, line the skulls up to go all the way down his arm the way the dragon was supposed to. And it came out 10 times better than what I did before. Now with the briefs, I mean with the tights idea, I really... every time I look at these tights, I cringe because I don't really like these tights no more. I wanted to do something different. But you got Majestic's face on there. A funny fucking animated Asian face, you know, with his eyes closed and to signify that he's Asian. It's so racist, but it's funny because it's how a lot of anime cartoons, especially the comical anime cartoons, draw their characters' faces with their eyes closed and things of that nature. And he got the dragon, he has a dragon, Japanese symbol for dragon behind his face. And then you got the bastards plastered everywhere on that damn thing. That's why I don't like it. But as you can see, it's the same kick pads that Orion has, but with the dragon symbol written in it. You know, I figured, you know, something different, something for Majestic. Now, Majestic himself, no one really knows exactly what Asian descent that he comes from. Nobody knows if he's Japanese, nobody knows if he's Chinese, nobody knows if he's Thai, nobody really knows what he is. He's just representing the entire Asian culture. Like, I will do some Chinese attires for him and whatnot, but I just don't know how to do it yet. And he's from Cleveland, Ohio. He's an American, but nobody knows his descent. And here goes Adelaide, somebody that you haven't seen yet up close, which I don't know why, when he's like one of my second favorite superstars of all time that I've ever created. Adolescent. It's just so fun creating him. Like, this attire right here, this attire is put together so well. Like, I'm not saying this because I drew it. It's just that if you look at my other attires and you look at this one, it just looks so neat. It looks so well put together. You have the green mushroom on the front for 1-Up, of course. And, of course, you got the 1-Ups on the side that says 1-Up. And that came out decent. That came out great. Of course, paint too. I mean, pixels. Anything that you see with pixels, you can draw it. And it comes out damn near the same. You got his face on the back. I know I already did the face for the bastards and whatnot, but I had to do his face because it was so fun at the time creating faces. I don't know why. And then you got the gloves. I don't know where I got the gloves idea from, but I got it from somewhere. I can't remember. I think I just Googled gloves and just decided to draw that paint tool. It was kind of hard to get that glove. I mean, the paint tool looking right on his hands. And then you got the kick pads. Like I said, this that attire is literally just like well put together. Like, if I didn't create this shit and somebody else did, I would say the same thing. Like, yo, the attire is awesome. Like, just looks great. You got the Nintendo controller on top, the regular Nintendo, and the whole kick pad just corresponds with the colors of the Nintendo controller and everything like that. And he doesn't have inches of tight. He was supposed to have inches of tight. It was like his face, and it says anime under it, but the Anna and the May is separated, so it's gonna say anime. Hey, I got that from Piggy. Yeah. And somebody you haven't seen yet, I think, is Punky right now. A lot of people don't even know this yet, but Punky is the girlfriend of Reckless. Hence why she has the whole Confederate themed attire going on, the same way Reckless does. But if you paid attention to NWF when they both were on the show, you can see that they both came out to the same music. I haven't put them together yet on the show yet, but they will be. But yeah, if you notice, they came out to the same music. They are like a faction. It's called Reckless Punk. They're like a little faction with each other. They boyfriend and girlfriend over here. That's Punky. I actually like the way this came out. It was random. Just threw the fucking Confederate shit everywhere. Not like, said she only got one boob covered with the Confederate flag. That was kind of decent. I like that. I didn't want to do it too much with the Confederate flag on the other side. And then we got me. Even though it don't look anything like me, because I can never get my face right at all. I think I need Smith, SD Smith, to do my face for me one good time. Because he made his character, and his character looked damn near just like it. But we got the Jordan t-shirt. It's actually the two sneakers put together to make it look like the Chicago Bulls logo. That is an actual t-shirt, by the way. I found that off of Google Images, and I was like, that's dope. I already drew the sneakers, so I was like, let me fucking just put them together and make that logo. And I did it in the sneaker in low res, and then I imported it to high res so I can put both, because I ain't have enough room to put both sneakers in there together. And of course, when you dumb it down or whatever the case may be, it just looks bad. But there go the infamous sneakers that you've seen from the Jordan Project. I got lazy and I was like, you know what, I'm not gonna fucking change my sneakers. I'm gonna have the same fucking sneakers on. I don't care what anybody says. And I just left those Jordans up there. It's like, I think the ones, the Jumpmans, whatever you wanna call it. I'm not a Jordan follower. I don't follow Jordan. So it's like, whoever knows Jordans knows exactly what Jordans those are. So there you have it. I got another tire that nobody ever seen yet. And here it is right now, the underdog attire. That's a paint tool that I made, and I just haven't shown it to anybody. I just made it, uploaded it to the community creations, put it on my attire, and just deleted it so I can have the space. But that's Glass Joe. For all of us old people out there that was around when the Nintendo came out and it had Punch-Out. Is a Nintendo game, a regular Nintendo, not Super Nintendo. Punch-Out was a game for the regular Nintendo, and the first person that you fight on Punch-Out is Glass Joe. Now Glass Joe is the easiest person on the game. You can beat, like, whoever has lost a Glass Joe need to be ashamed of himself, because I don't think it's possible to lose a Glass Joe. Glass Joe record was like 0 in a million. Like, when you see his record is like 0 in a million and whatnot, like, he never wins. But I decided, you know, let me draw Glass Joe. I'm gonna make that shit an underdog t-shirt, because Glass Joe is like the biggest underdog in the history of underdogs. Like, and it was supposed to be a freaking adolescent attire, since he got the whole video game concept going on. It was supposed to be an adolescent t-shirt, but I was like, you know what? Fuck it, I need another attire for the second episode, so let me just throw on my attire. Then we got Angel. For what it is, I'm not really too fond of this attire. when I first created it, I was like, okay, it's decent. When I first created it, I honestly could tell you that I really didn't like it when I first created it. But, and he got that lackluster tattoo, which I think I might just take off because Andrew ain't having any tattoos to begin with. I think I might just take that shit off because I don't, really doesn't go well with whatever the hell it was I was doing. And then you got the trunks. The trunks are meant to be this way. I did not want to put that design on both sides, so don't say, oh, you should put the design on both sides. I didn't want to do that. It was supposed to be this way. I didn't want to go too extravagant with this dude attire right here. And that was the case, but I don't know. Like I said, I'm not too fond of this attire at all. I mean, we got the kick pads right now with the wings and shit. That you already seen those kick pads is the reason why you're seeing it now. He was supposed to be like a surprise or whatever, but I guess he's not a surprise anymore since you already knew he had kick pads or you know he was in the game. Yeah, trying to do something different, but I really didn't like the way this shit came out. But then we got the entrance attire, this fucking coat. Oh my god. I challenge anybody out there. I challenge any and everybody out there, actually, to create a design for this coat. Like, you can, like, you don't even have to create a character. All the paint tool, all the slots, all the layers, everything, you can just use it on the coat. I want to see somebody come up with an awesome design for this coat. As you can see, I got Angel on the back of that shit. And when he spreads his arms, you see the whole word Angel. That's for the fact that he has the Jericho entrance where he comes out and he stands there with his arms stretched out. And that's the first thing you see is Angel written across his back on the shit. Like, his wings and whatnot. Like, the shit is dope. The idea was dope. But goddamn, this is so hard to get that A and that L in that fucking position. It is so hard. Like, you have to move it slightly. Go back to the fucking menu pose, the menu screen pose, to see if it's placed in the right direction. And you gotta keep going back and forth, back and forth, back and forth to see if you got it in the right spot. And it's just so hard. But here is his second attire. It's an Alberto Del Rio idea attire. It's not exactly Alberto Del Rio's attire, but it's, I got the idea from it. You got the A on the front, and you got the wing on the side. Now the wings, of course, we all know that the wings are not wings on Alberto Del Rio's attire. It's actually a bird. I don't know if it's an eagle or whatever it is, but it's a bird. I decided to change the front to making it to, like, you know, abstract wings or whatever. And, you know, looking at it, I think the wings clashes with the lines behind it, like the golden lines behind it. But, you know, it's decent from what it is. I didn't really like it when I first made it, but then, like, when I seen it, I was like, this is kind of decent. And then the way the knee pads came out actually made the attire look better than me. Like, for some reason, his knee pads, I was going for, like, Dolph Ziggler knee pads, the way his knee pads are shaped. But for some reason, it came out looking like a Billy Gunn type knee pads. I don't know, but. And then another coat idea, another frustrating fucking coat design that I tried. Now, I had tried the whole wings on the side of his tights. I tried to put that on the wings of the coat, so when he spreads his wings, you actually see that design. But the design, the way the design was shaped and everything like that, it wasn't, you know, masked out properly for that type of idea that I had, so it looks weird, but it's still decent. I like this attire way better than the first one, and of course I got those boots that Donny Don hates. I don't know why I love those boots. And then we got Tyru. Tyru is a Japanese dude that I'm experimenting with right now. Those ribbons on the back is supposed to be an extension of his hair, like he has a mohawk going down into like a ponytail type shit. And Tyru, his nickname is going to be the Japanese Scarface or whatever, because his face is scarred due to, like, and, like, his only his left side of his face is scarred, and his chest is scarred on the left side and things of that nature, because he's like one of those hardcore type indie wrestler dudes. And yeah, his briefs is cool. They are cool. Not too fond of it, but they're decent. You dig what I'm saying? Like, I can keep it there. because they're decent, but you got the Japanese letters behind the actual design. I don't know what the hell the Japanese letters say, but hey, I seen it on Attack 2 and I was like, hey, that's cool, I'm gonna do those letters. You got a flame that curves around the back to the side and creates the name Taru. It was supposed to be like a flame design, but hey. And here is my favorite part about this character right now, is the knee pads. I fucking love the way these knee pads came out. And I think these are the best knee pads I have ever seen created on the fucking game. Not because I created it, but because the way they came out. They came out looking awesome. And he has the little boots. Now, I wanted to do something different because I never see anybody you try to make those little boots. Kurt Angle, they make Kurt Angle and they make Roderick Strong, and it just doesn't look right because those boots, they don't give him the right boots and they don't try to create the little boots. But I try to create the little boots, and I know the skin on his calves do not match. Don't ask. I mean, don't say it. I would change it. Just didn't change it yet. And whatever. He's still going to be experimented on, and his attire should be different the next time you see him. But until then, I am Insanity, and this is a long-ass call update. Part 12.